Look at that guy! He thinks he's plants!
Howdy, vitamin and vitawomen and everyone in between. Trey's here with some brain nutrition for you for D News. Vitamin D is everywhere in our diets these days, sort of. You can get it in cereal, milk, orange juices, and other fortified foods, as well as in fatty fish, egg yolks, and a few other places. But mostly, vitamin D comes from you, from your skin. You make it. Vitamin D is actually a group of 5 fat-soluble molecules, and it's the main animal version, D3, that promotes the absorption of calcium for our bones. Without vitamin D, adults can experience osteomalacia, pain and weakness, and children can develop rickets, a softening of the bone's growth plates, which can lead to bowed legs. Bottom line, D3, it's real important. But let's get back to this skin thing. Plants have photosynthesis, right? Well, we have dermal vitamin synthesis. Deep in the skin is a steroid called 7-dehydrocholesterol. And when that is hit by UVB radiation from the sun's photons break one of its chemical bonds, which convert it to cholecalciferol, the science name for vitamin D3. Once the D3 is created, the liver and kidneys convert that to its final form, calcitriol. Whew, it's a process, but it all starts with exposure from a nuclear fusion ball millions of miles away. Science is awesome. Once created in the kidneys, a protein called DBP, or vitamin D binding protein, grabs it and transports it to the organs where it starts a cascade of effects, from building bones by balancing the calcium and phosphate in the body to maintaining nervous system function. Vitamin D is even essential in helping DNA to express between 100 and 1,250 genes. There are also studies which hypothesize vitamin D, or calcitriol, helps treat autoimmune diseases, diabetes, infections, cognitive degeneration, and cancer, and can prevent heart disease. This stuff is apparently awesome, which is why we started putting it everywhere. Studies in Boston found in 1900, 80-85% of children were afflicted with the skeletal devastation that is rickets, all from a lack of vitamin D. So, in the 1930s, the US government asked food companies to add vitamin D or cod liver oil to their products in a process called fortification, hoping to eradicate the rickets problem. Milk and cereal producers have been adding vitamin D to their Moo juice and flakes ever since, and it has worked as rickets has been virtually eliminated in most of the West today. The thing is, remember, there are 5 forms of vitamin D. And food processors don't add D3, the stuff we make in our skin, they add a different version, D2, ergo calciferol. Plant vitamin D, not animal. Allegedly, our body treats them both the same, though that debate is ongoing, with some scientists saying it's less efficient for the body to convert, so you need it more than if you just went outside. You can get all the D3 you need with as little as 5 to 15 minutes of direct sunlight on your hands, arms, and face. So for all the chatter and praise vitamin D gets from the media, you just make it. However, if you're worried, yeah, you can have too much, but it's hard. Vitamin D toxicity is more of a risk for people taking vitamin supplements and can cause an increase in calcium levels, which results in heart arrhythmias, decreased appetite, and increased urination. It can even cause nausea, vomiting, disorientation, and the like. Your body is trying to get all of that excess calcium out, but you'd have to drink more than 40 cups of milk per day to exceed the maximum daily dose. So it's more important to be careful with calcium supplements instead, which again are D2, not D3. They work, but remember, there's a debate. Vitamin D is just one of many vitamins and minerals the body needs every single day. It really struck me that the process of making it from the sun is super complicated. Evolution is amazing. Speaking of all those vitamins, do they really improve your health? Check out this video to find out.
Smokers were given a daily supplement of vitamin E, beta carotene, both, or placebo. Now, the group taking the supplements were more likely to die of lung cancer or heart disease. In the second study, the group that took supplements were dying from lung cancer at a rate 28% higher than those who didn't.
Do you stand in the sun for 5 minutes or more a day, or would you rather just take a pill and drink some milk? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more D News, and we'll see you next time.